Brad's here with sport. Brad, huge anticipation in the boxing world.
This is going to be great, we hope. Tonight's IBF world title fight between Anthony Mundine and Daniel Gill is about to get underway at the Sydney Entertainment Centre. We are joined live now by reporter Liam Cox. Liam, not far away. How's the atmosphere in there?
Brad, the atmosphere is electric. We have 12,000 people here, plenty of A-listers, and the pre-bout, we saw Kimbo Slice. He's the street-fighting American. He's a crazy dude. He's a big unit, and he gave a big kidney punch to poor old Shane Tilliard, the Queensland miner. He got $40,000 for this fight. I don't know if that was worth it because he copped an absolute beating. Now, this is a prelude to the IBF World Championship middleweight fight between Anthony Mundine and Daniel Gill. Now, there has been so much controversy in the lead up to this fight, and all of that controversy has been from Anthony Mundine. There was some talk about a week ago that he might turn his back on the Australian national anthem. Now, I think that is about to start, but I've got the tip off. Crisis averted. Both boxers will be in their dressing rooms while the national anthem is played. So that is a massive, potentially front page headlines from Anthony Mundine, and not headlines that you want, have been averted. Now to the fight. Well, Daniel Gill, he's in the prime of his career. He's 32 years old. He's just come back from Germany. He's a world title holder. He's the red-hot favourite for this fight. Anthony Mundine, well, look, he's a great athlete, but he's on the downward spiral. Look, it's a two-horse race. Anything can happen. Anthony Mundine's in the best shape of his career, but it's really hard to see Daniel Gill getting beaten here tonight. There's so much anticipation. There's been so much hype in the lead-up to this fight. If the action out there is anything like the hype has been, I think we're in for one of the greatest fights of all time.
I can imagine, mate. Hey, we better let you go. It'd be a shame to be there and miss it.
I've got ringside seats. I think the sweat of Anthony Mundine will be flying in my face. So I better get back to it.
We're very jealous. I'd love to be there. We'll hear all about it tomorrow. Of course. Now, cricket, and Usman Khawaja is on his way to Perth to replace David Warner in the Australian side for the first two one-dayers against the West Indies. As Lockie Reid reports, Warner broke his thumb at training tonight. He could now miss the tour of India.
The Aussie Master Blaster was batting in the second net when rapped on the hand. David Warner has been the summer's shining light, but his immediate playing future is now in serious limbo. The opener in immense pain, and while he was consoled by his teammates and medicos, the injury was deemed so serious he was rushed to hospital for scans. Warner's performance at the top of the order has been rock solid. The latest blow to his thumb on his batting hand could spell trouble for Australia's 2013 campaign. The culprit, Mitchell Johnson, hoping Warner will make a speedy recovery and nervous about his selection for the upcoming tour of India.
Hopefully my experience does come into account, but you got to go by form in the end. You know, if you're performing, then you should be picked and playing.
Rotated out of the New South Wales side today, Brad Haddin could also find himself preparing for India. Matthew Wade's in different form with the gloves, set to force selectors to take a second keeper. But the Victorian is adamant he's not feeling the pressure.
Brad's playing really well. You know, he deserves his spot if he gets a spot in the upcoming tours and the Ashes. Personally, I don't feel too much pressure.
Michael Clarke will play Friday, while all-rounder James Faulkner is the flavour of the week. He joined the one-day squad today, fresh from a man-of-the-match performance for the Prime Minister's 11. He backed up an unbeaten 44 with four wickets in the PM's victory over the Windies, the tourists falling 23 runs short, despite a half-century off 24 deliveries from Andre Russell.
Russell again. Jeez, he can hit a ball. That's his third monster six.
He finished with five, the last of which made its way out of Manuka Oval. Lockie Reid, 10 News.
Well, thankfully, Shane Watson wasn't injured today, but he did fail with the bat in his return to domestic one-day duties. Watson made just six runs for New South Wales before falling to West Australian debutant Joel Parris.
Ooh. Oh, that could be close, and that's given. What about that from Joel Parris?
The highlight of the game, this brilliant catch by Warriors batsman Sean Marsh. Things didn't improve for the Blues. They were belted by 111 runs. It is the Warriors' first win at the SCG since 1996. The AFL will continue with its three strikes policy after unanimous endorsement by clubs, the league and its players. In a nine-hour meeting on drugs between members from all facets of the game, as well as medical staff and police, The AFL agreed to tighten the loophole which has seen players self-report substance use to avoid a strike.
In their view, it's not an issue that's being exploited to the extent it's been reported. But it is an issue to close that loophole so that it doesn't get exploited.
The league will also adopt a working committee to meet annually on the drugs issue. Tonight's play of the day is bigger than Ben Hur, and Ben Hur was big, apparently. Hawaiian surfer Garrett McNamara believes he's broken his own world record for riding the largest wave of all time. Look at this. How big is it? McNamara says it was an incredible 30 metres. That would beat his previous record, this is it here, by 7 metres, for having the courage to ride the 30-metre monster off the coast of Portugal. Garrett McNamara carves up our play of the day.
You'd have to be absolutely fearless to ride something like that, surely.
Talking of big, Kimbo Slice.
He is some sort of man mountain.
Huge.
How excited was Liam Cox? He's going to enjoy that fight, isn't he?
Oh, he's so excited.
Who's your tip there, Brad?
Gil.
Controversial. All right, thanks, Brad.